Hello, I'm Christina Unarut, Technical Marketing Engineer with Mouser Electronics. Welcome to another Mouser Bench Talk. Today, I'll be introducing you to the DIGI ConnectCore 8X SBC Pro Development Kit. DIGI is committed to IoT solutions. Connected IoT devices around the world will transmit over 430 trillion bytes of data across different applications in smart cities, medical operations, and industrial environments. DIGI offers sensor-based solutions, a sophisticated platform for remotely monitoring device deployments of any size, anywhere, as well as professional design, implementation, and certification teams. DIGI ConnectCore 8X SBC Pro Development Kit delivers a powerful, secure, and cost-effective single-board computer platform with complete support for Linux and Android. This kit is designed to reduce time to market by virtually eliminating the traditional risk, effort, and complexity of a custom board design, all without sacrificing flexibility or capabilities. The compact form factor integrates an onboard dual-band antenna, USB connectivity, and DIGI XB RF connector. Another product that we are using in this demonstration is the ConnectCore 6 LCD application kit. It is a 10-inch WXGA LCD panel with projected capacitive touch. In this video, we will demonstrate how to create a touchscreen interface system with Wi-Fi connectivity features. In addition to this video, there will be a project article linked below with more detailed step-by-step instructions. Setting up the hardware can be done in a few steps. Connecting the LCD display. Connecting the USB-C cable between the board and the development PC. Plugging in the USB serial cable between the console connector on the board to the development PC. And make sure that the two boot switches are placed in the off position. Once the hardware is all set up, we can move on to the software setup. You'll need to install the Universal Update Utility from Ubuntu Software Application page, then install Android Studio from the same page. The last step will be to install the terminal emulation software. For the next following steps, please refer to the project article for additional instructions. With the options for embedded Yocto and Android available, we will be demonstrating how to install a modified version of embedded Android 11. Once this is complete, we will be registering your device with DIGI Remote Manager. The connection to DIGI Remote Manager will not only allow you to monitor devices, but also push firmware updates, install, and update applications, and provide access to file system upload, download, or remove files. Along with these features, you can also configure alerts to notify you of preset conditions as well as automate operations across one or more of these connected devices. Now we need to set up Android Studio. DIGI provides a wide array of sample applications that can be executed to test different features available to the development board. Applications that provide access to the CAN bus, GPIO, I2C, and more. For this demo, we will be showing the Getting Started sample application. Once the app builds and programs the development board, you should see the app load on the LCD screen. From here, you can bring the LED as indicated, as well as control the interval. Following these instructions, you can go back and try any of the other samples, or simply use Android Studio to create your own. Paired with the DIGI Remote Manager, monitoring and managing multiple interfaces can be simple and efficient. I hope you can see how quickly you can get your project up and running with the DIGI ConnectCore 8X SBC Pro Development Kit and other resources provided by DIGI. This product and others are available at Mouser. And be sure to check out our other Bench Talk videos for more product demos and instructions.